What's up, it's your boy Edo, aka The Nut. I am the Notorious One. Got a chance to catch up with k-Rino at the four-piece listening party.
You have messages for the older ones, older than us. What would your message be for the younger ones, younger than us?
The message to y'all would be to don't wait until you get 15, 17, 18, 19, 20 to try to figure out what you want to be. Start figuring it out right now, you know. And to for the parents to observe what you're doing. I'm just trying to
win and make my mama proud. So I got to spend a few minutes, a few personal minutes with k-Rino. I wanted to ask him a few questions, pick his brain on things that are going on.
Tonight, folks, you're paying respects to a woman who was shot and killed during a confrontation with a Baytown police officer.
To open up an investigation for civil rights under color of law.
Yo.
As to whether she was discriminated because of her race and sex.
It's not a black matter, it's not a white matter, it's a right matter. Pamela Turner's rights were violated.
And the Baytown Police Department tells us the officer involved is back on the job, but that he is on desk duty until an investigation is done.
The BLEXIT.
So explain for us what BLEXIT is and how you came up with the idea. You were watching a television.
Yes, the black exit from the Democrat Party, because it's time that we stop allowing them to use us for votes and deliver none of the promises that they ensure every election cycle.
And the no-knock raid.
I don't trust being in my own home near that home. Because I don't know if someone's gonna knock down my door.
People are furious and they're letting the police chief of Houston know it after a botched drug raid last month that killed a husband and wife in their home.
All right, let's get to that clip. Houston's finest living legend, the man k-Rino. Just want to pick your brain, man. That's all.
Let's get the ice pick out and let's do it.
First question. What do you think about Pamela Turner, man, aka Baytown shooting?
Yeah, she was murdered. Basically, new information just came out in an autopsy report that showed that she was actually, one of the shots was to her face. So you cannot tell me that you as an officer was in fear of your life when you shoot a defenseless female five times, and one of those shots is to the face. So this was a murder, make no mistake about it. This was not a situation where it was a self-defense on the behalf of the officer. And once again, it's another case where a black person was unjustly murdered by law enforcement. So justice for Pam Turner, that's where we at.
Straight up. The other question I want to ask you about BLEXIT, man. What you think about BLEXIT?
Man, I've heard of it, but I just don't really know the
it's
game
basically
like that.
African-American saying, Democrat Party, we don't necessarily belong to you. We don't necessarily need you.
I agree with that, yeah. I mean, the thing is, we have made the mistake of picking parties in this political process since slavery. And neither one has been of any benefit to us as a people. They are both two different wings on the same bird. So when I see black people argue about Republican versus Democrat, yeah, it's really a waste of time. Neither has been an asset to us since our time in this country. And the quicker we learn that, the better. Because if you know anything about these political parties, they all in bed together anyway. Yeah. You know, so at the end of the day, Bush and Clinton were mortal enemies until they got out of office, and now they traveling the world doing so-called benefits together back in the day. So it's all a scam, and anybody who was withdrawing their support from this political system is a wise person, in my opinion, because it's never, ever gonna benefit the black or the brown, and that's a fact.
No-knock raid here in Houston. Yeah. They killed the couple.
Right.
What you think about that, bro?
Well, it's just a situation where the media messed up the story again, and we've been suffering from that forever.
Yeah.
You know, so it's always unfortunate when people get caught up in those types of situations, because it creates tension within the community among the citizens and law enforcement. But it is what it is, man. We have to be more adept in policing our own communities. And once we kind of fall into that mind frame, then we can prevent a lot of these scenarios from taking place, because even the police will know that they can't just come running up in somewhere and just doing whatever it is they feel like they should do. So the onus is on us as a community and as men to police our own community, because too many of us get murdered. And in this particular case, it wasn't us. And part of that was some part of the media's misconstruing the story in the beginning in some aspects. So, I mean, we have to take the reins and police in our community. It's that simple. Yeah. And if law enforcement has no fear of consequence from the people, they're going to continue. We're going to continue to see these random acts of terrorism with law enforcement.
Straight up.
That's all it is.
That was beautiful, brother.
Thank you, man. I appreciate you. I appreciate you coming through, man.
Yes, sir.
Love, man.
Settle in, we're about to begin. In debates over this topic, we're seeing an influx.